everybody. James has just finished putting on his pack. Had several people come in after dark and set up right here by the shelter. The sun is coming up. It's a glorious morning, not a cloud in the sky. The stars were so bright this morning when I went to get the bear bag. Brighter than any stars I've seen in years. But we're going to go ahead and get started. Looks like about a 13-mile day, but James just informed me that the weather had changed the forecast, and there could be 1 to 4 inches of snow tonight and in continuing into Saturday as we hike that final 13 miles into Irwin, Tennessee. So we're going to have to bundle up, and it's going to be winter again. Rise and shine. This is indeed the calm before the storm. So we're just coming underneath this interstate here, and we get to this little box where you cross, and there was 2 Coca-Colas right in that little cubby. So thank you so much, whoever placed those there. We will enjoy those and gain some encouragement. And I want to say a quick word on my material and the content I'm putting up on YouTube. First and foremost, for me and James, me and Steps, because we've been hiking together since 2016, enjoying day hikes, a couple overnights, those sort of things. But I do put quite a bit of content on there, and the reason I do is because I like to document every single day. To me, day hikes are the bomb. I mean, even the Appalachian Trail through hike, any through hike, regardless of the distance and how many days, weeks, months it takes, they're just a bunch of snapshots of day hikes. And then overnight and do another day hike. So I feel confident that I'm giving a great representation of the whole Appalachian Trail in these videos. And I like to highlight each day at a time. Each day has a life of its own. And most people, including me up until this through hike, are just day hikers anyway. And that's where it's at. So I'm trying to include enough material that each hike stands on its own. Most of the episodes, as you've seen, are single days. Every now and then I'll throw in 2 days on an episode, and I'll continue to do that as it works out that way. But I don't want to have any videos that are longer than 30 minutes. The Smokies, there was so much material. That's why 3 in a row turned out to be 20 plus minutes. Ideally, I'm trying to fit them in, you know, 10 to 15 minutes, but it really doesn't matter what I say. It's what the trail dictates, right? I'm not the Appalachian Trail. I'm not a day hike. Whatever's presented to us, we'll document and give it to you, the viewer. So, day hikers, continue to get out there. Those of you who haven't hiked much, go on a day hike, even just a mile or two. There is so much out there you see on these videos, just little things. And boy, I tell you, there's so much more that happens that we don't document, Steps and myself. We have to pick and choose so as not to overwhelm. And, I know you've got the fast forward button on the video, so if you feel overwhelmed, I'm sure you're skipping ahead. But anyway, that's why there's so much content to make a record for us, our family, our friends, you, the viewers all over the world. But I really want to do a great job of getting enough photos and video that you feel like when you're done watching these, you got a great representation of the entire trail, and you got it one day hike at a time. right, so we're heading over there to Big Bald
and praying that the weather doesn't set in before we get on top, about 4.5 miles or so. So I know you can see the snow now. It's coming down and it's just gonna get heavier. So I wanna go ahead and speak now before we are covered in it. This makes me excited, y'all. I tell you, snow to a southern boy makes me feel like a 5-year-old ready to run outdoors and build Frosty. It's like a kiss from winter wonderland, you know, and 1 to 4 inches, what's the difference to somebody from the panhandle of Florida? It's exciting. So there is certainly a hazy shade of winter that has settled in on this area. And I can only imagine what it's gonna look like in just a little while, so. I would like to say to all of you out there that can relate, who gets giddy about snow, get ready and enjoy. So there again is another outstanding example of the power of the community on the trail and hiking, getting outdoors. There was 3 generations of lovely people. The mother, trail named Freedom, and she looks free. Then we've got her daughter, Ryan, who, by the way, is still looking for a trail name, and I have a feeling before the end of the day, Miss Freedom will probably tag her with one. And then that sweet baby girl, attached to Ryan. I don't know her, well, I won't reveal her real name, but I kind of tagged her with one that I know you're watching right now. As an older young lady, you are Snow Angel, because you're certainly a beautiful angel. So don't let that one stay with you the rest of your life, unless you really just like it. I'm sure you'll get tagged with other trail names when you grow up and get out on the trails yourself. And then, of course, their beautiful golden puppy dog. Today, you, my friend, man's best friend, you will be called Snowflake.
Ooh.
safely at camp for the day. We did our 13 point something miles. Look at this water source, y'all. Spring right out of the mountainside, and it can't be any cooler. This is my new favorite water source ever, because look at what's happening all around me. Yeah, it could be raining right now. I'm very thankful for snow. So I just hung the bear bag, and we have some snow sticking, don't you think? And I'm a little worried that I'll get a lot tonight. I just wiped off that left side with my rain mitt. You see how much came off. So wipe this side and this side, and then just hope for the best during the night. Once again, good night.